Solve the given quadratic inequality, give the answer using interval notation. To begin, we need to write the quadratic inequality in standard form, which means we need to subtract 15 on both sides and write the inequality as 3x squared plus 6x minus 15 less than or equal to 0. Step 2, we determine the critical points, which are the zeros or solutions of the related quadratic equation, which means we now need to solve 3x squared plus 6x minus 15 equals 0. Let's see if we can factor. The first step in factoring is to factor out the greatest common factor, which in this case is 3, giving us 3 times the quantity x squared plus 2x minus 5 equals 0. Unfortunately, x squared plus 2x minus 5 is not factorable. There are no factors of negative 5 that add to positive 2, which means to find the critical points, we'll have to use the quadratic formula, which I've shown here on the right. Where notice a is equal to 1, b is equal to 2, and c is equal to negative 5, which gives us x equals negative b is negative 2 plus or minus the square root of b squared is the square of 2 minus 4ac gives us minus 4 times 1 times negative 5, all divided by 2 times a, which is 2 times 1. Simplifying further, we have negative 2 plus or minus the square root of 4 plus 20, or 24, all divided by 2. And now we need to simplify the square root of 24. Well, the square root of 24 is equal to the square root of 4 times 6. The square root of 4 is 2, giving us 2 square root 6. So now we have x equals negative 2 plus or minus 2 square root 6, all divided by 2. Let's break this up into two parts. We have x equals negative 2 divided by 2 plus or minus 2 square root 6 divided by 2, which is equal to negative 1 plus or minus square root 6. So we have two critical points, which we now need to plot on the number line. And we always plot critical points as open points or closed points based upon the original inequality. Because our inequality is less than or equal to, this means the critical points are going to be part of the solution, and therefore we make closed points at the critical points. Now remember here, there's two values. One is negative 1 minus square root 6, and the other is negative 1 plus square root 6. And negative 1 minus square root 6 is less. So we'll make a closed point here on the left and label it negative 1 minus square root 6. And on the right, we'll have negative 1 plus square root 6. The next step is to select test values in each of the intervals that we've created. To do this, it might be helpful to get a decimal approximation for these two irrational critical points. Negative 1 minus square root 6 is approximately negative 3.45, and negative 1 plus square root 6 is approximately 1.45. And now let's go ahead and select our test points or test values. On the left, we'll use x equals negative 4. In the middle, we'll use x equals 0. On the right, we'll use x equals 2. And now we need to sub these values into the inequality. If the test value is true, the entire interval is true and part of the solution. If the test value is false, the entire interval is false and not part of the solution. Let's use the inequality in this form here. We could also use the factored form here, but let's go ahead and just use the standard form. So we'll use the inequality 3x squared plus 6x minus 15 less than or equal to 0 for the test. Now let's go ahead and test x equals negative 4. So when x is negative 4, the square of negative 4 is 16. 3 times 16 is 48. And then we have plus 6 times negative 4, which simplifies to minus 24, minus 15, which is going to be positive. Any positive value is never going to be less than or equal to 0. And therefore, the test value does not satisfy the inequality. We mark the interval as false. And now we test x equals 0. When x equals 0 on the left, we have 0 plus 0 minus 15 less than or equal to 0, which is true. We mark the middle interval as true. And finally, we test x equals 2. When x equals 2, the square of 2 is 4. 3 times 4 is 12. Plus 6 times 2 is plus 12. Minus 15, this result is positive. A positive value is not going to be less than or equal to 0. And therefore, we mark the interval on the right as false. Analyzing the number line, the graph of the solution is the closed interval from negative 1 minus square root 6 to negative 1 plus square root 6. Let's write this using interval notation. Because the endpoints are included, we use square brackets. Before we go, let's look at the graph of the related quadratic function on the coordinate plane to verify the solution. Let's consider the quadratic inequality in the form of 3x squared plus 6x minus 15 less than or equal to 0. To verify the solution, we graph f of x or y equals 3x squared plus 6x minus 15, which we see here in orange. Notice the x-intercepts are negative 1 minus square root 6 and negative 1 plus square root 6, because this is the graph of y equals 3x squared plus 6x minus 15, and we're looking for the solution of 3x squared plus 6x minus 15 less than or equal to 0. We're looking for the part of the graph where y is equal to 0 or less than 0. Well, we know y is equal to 0 at the x-intercepts here and here, and y is negative when the graph is below the x-axis, which is this part of the graph. And therefore, the solution are the x-values for which the graph is below or on the x-axis, which our graph verifies is the closed interval from negative 1 minus square root 6 to negative 1 plus square root 6. I hope you found this helpful.